What kind of math and science do you use?
The way we think about our videos is not in compartments like this part is colors, that part is sounds, this part is gravity, right? We think, wouldn't it be amazing if we could make this thing? And then we figure out all the supporting elements we need. So the different videos require different types of thinking, but there's often a lot of math and science, and that will break down into things that you might call geometry or algebra or physics. But the truth is, all of those things are really connected. They're in school, we have to learn in categories often because there's so much out there to learn. They have to kind of narrow it down to figure out what you're going to focus on today. But you know, when we were in high school and in junior high and middle school, I remember learning things and thinking, well, I mean, who has to know algebra, right? But we use algebra all the time. Because algebra, when it's abstract, when you're just learning the tools, it's sort of like learning scales on a guitar. Like, it's not that fun. But then when you get good at using the guitar, you're not playing scales anymore, you're playing music, right? So for us, the types of science and math, we don't recognize them as different. It's sort of like, if we want to do something cool with liquids, well, we know that viscous liquids move more slowly than really thin liquids do, or that liquids act differently in microgravity than solids do. And I don't remember where I learned those things. I just know that for my whole life I've been curious, and math and science fed that curiosity and let me be able to chase these things.